When there is a need to increase the current capacity of a voltage source, then cells or batteries are connected in parallel. Here we have three cells connected in parallel, all positive terminals connected together and all negative terminals connected together. When cells or batteries are connected in parallel, they are connected across each other, positive to positive and negative to negative. The rules of the parallel arrangement of voltage sources are just the reverse of the rules of the series arrangement of voltage sources. Instead of the voltage being additive and current remaining the same, the voltage remains the same and the current is additive. More precisely stated, the rules are, first, total EMF is the same as that of the individual cells. In equation form, this is V sub t equals V sub 1 equals V sub 2 equals V sub n. And second, since the individual cells are arranged to form more than one current path, the total current equals the sum of the currents from the individual cells. Looking at the water pump analogy again will help to envision why the current increases. Whereas in a series arrangement, the pumps built on each other and had only one conduit, this setup has three different conduits pumping up to the one reservoir. Thus, the voltage remains 1.5 volts, but the current is additive. Let's see what increased current means in the case of a simple circuit. As we saw earlier, with only one voltage cell connected to this circuit, the lamp glows. What will happen this time if another cell is connected in parallel with the first? Will the lamp glow more brightly? Let's see. As you can see, the added cell does not increase the brightness of the lamp. Even though the parallel connection has doubled the available current, the voltage, the work that the electrons are able to do in the lamp, remains the same, and therefore the lamp's brightness does not change. If the filament of the lamp still lets through the same amount of electrons, what is the advantage of extra current? The answer is time. This lamp will now glow for twice the amount of time it would have glowed before when only one cell was acting as the voltage source for the circuit. The current capacity is increased. The term ampere hours, abbreviated A-HR, is used to indicate the current capacity of a cell. In other words, how much current the cell can supply for a period of time. For instance, 0.5 ampere hours means that a cell will deliver 1/2 ampere for 1 hour. 2 ampere hours means that the cell could deliver 2 amperes for 1 hour, or 1 ampere for 2 hours, or 1/2 ampere for 4 hours. It all depends on the amount of current allowed to flow by the load. This is the conductivity of the load, as we'll study in our next lesson. For now, let's see an example of the current capacity of parallel connected cells. In this circuit, there are three cells connected in parallel. Since each cell is rated for 0.5 ampere hours, if we tally on the ampere side of the ampere hour ratio, this parallel connection of voltage sources could deliver 1.5 amperes to a load for 1 hour. Tallying on the time side of the ampere hour ratio, this same parallel connection of voltage sources could deliver 0.5 amperes to a load for 3 hours. In either case, the voltage would remain the same, 1.5 volts.